Hey, sorry, man.
Yeah, sorry. Going to Williamsburg, North 6 and Y.
Do you mind? I'll just hang on to you. Can you just drop me off at Williamsburg Bridge? That's fine, because I'm headed to the Bowery. Do you mind?
All right, we'll just split a fare. That's fine. Two stops.
Chambers Street.
Just take the FDR drive.
No, don't take Chambers Street.
First of all, I do this every single day. It's going to take an extra 20 minutes. I got to be somewhere. I promise. Take the FDR drive, please. It's going to be a lot faster.
I just think we can hang down the West Side Highway and make a left on Chambers Street.
There's no point, though. It's
going
to be...
Bleecker, guys. We're going Bleecker.
No. We both want to go to the same area. Bleecker Street is totally out of the direction.
That's ridiculous.
How about this? Both of you... out of the cab.
Wait a second.
Calm down, man. We're not going to get out of the cab.
We have the same range. We're just not going to go to Bleecker Street.
Out of my cab.
Hey, sweetheart. How you doing? It's me. I'm doing good. Thinking of you. Yeah, I dreamt about you last night, so I'm ready for you. At my Wheaties. I miss you too. You ready? Okay, I got some surprises.
Oh, magnifique.
Excusez-moi, mademoiselle.
This yours?
It is. It must have fallen out of my bag.
It was on the floor near the bathroom.
That was really nice of you. How can I thank you?
I wouldn't mind if you bought me a drink.
Great. What would you like?
Whatever you're having.
Two gin and tonics, no ice. Losing your cell phone's like losing your mind. Do you come here a lot?
I do. A lot. Too much. Long story.
Tell me. I've got a ton of time.
I only saw my dad once in my whole life, right here. When my mom was pregnant with me, she never told him, just left him. Growing up, she had a lot of boyfriends, went through one after another, but always left him. Every time she'd leave a man, though, she'd keep something, like a souvenir, you know, maybe a book or a necklace or a painting. When she left my dad, she kept me. I was her souvenir. Before she died, she gave me a piece of paper with his name and number on it. I called him up and we met here. I said one thing to him.
What'd you say?
Dad.
That's it?
I'm a gift for you from Mom.
Thank you.
I walk past your flower room every day. I see you, but I say nothing. I'm so afraid to look at you. Oh, girl, you say I'm the strongest, I say you're the kindest. You ask me where I'm going, I point to the ocean. Oh, girl.
Very touching.
Lyrics to this song.
Let me have a cigarette. Indian?
I think it's Japanese.
Chinese.
Chinese?
Xiexie. What's up? Bukapu.
Onkreab means.
Thank you. I fuck, and you're off key.
He found my phone for me.
Really? Very nice. Yeah. Thank you. Gary, nice to meet you.
Ben.
How are you, Benjamin?
Just Ben.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. I'll leave you two alone.
Have a seat. Sit. Sit down. You know each other?
It's possible.
You look familiar.
You know, New York's not such a big place.
You study? NYU?
I wish.
I teach there. Am I a good teacher?
You're a good teacher.
Thank you. So what do you do?
Thief. Could be.
That is funny.
Might be. Used to be. Will be. To be or not to be.
Come on, I'm a thief. I've been trying to steal you from your wife and it hasn't worked so far.
Can I get the bill?
You lost your wallet? You lost your wallet. Is this yours?
Wow. Yeah, that's my wallet.
Merci beaucoup.
Money's gone. I recently lost my wallet, but I managed to get my money back. A young man should never be without cash. Knock yourself out, young man.
You lost your wallet? Did you lose my pictures too?
Pictures? How could I?
How did you get these? I took these like 5 minutes ago. Why aren't you full of surprises today? You took off your ring.
Ben, your keys.
City only to do this deal, so it better be good. My customer wants Nats ASAP. I'm in the middle of my wedding arrangements, but I came here to do this business with you.
Who are you getting married to?
His name's Chaim.
Chaim in the mood for love. So where's my invitation for your wedding?
Did you invite me to your wedding?
Oh, I wish I had. 25 years I've been trading with Hasidic people. I know nothing about them. They know nothing about Jain peoples.
Strictly business. We don't come to 47th Street to chit-chat.
While you inspect the goods, I'm going to eat. Excuse me.
Hmm? You can't eat meat, right, you Hindus?
No, we are no Hindus. We are Jains. Hinduism is too materialistic for us. No meat, no fish. And what can't you eat?
No pig, no shrimp. What else can't you eat?
No onion, no garlic.
No milk and meat together.
No potato, no roots.
Nothing that hasn't been blessed.
Nothing too spicy. It is exciting the passions, you know.
The Christians, they eat everything. They're like the Chinese. They never have to spend too much time picking a restaurant.
That's why there are no Christians in the diamond market. How can you trust a person who will eat anything?
This parcel's not so good. At least 20% rejection you've given me. How much?
A parcel to kidla?
550. Too much. Way too much. I give you 480.
Why are you doing this to me? My children will be crying at home. Because after I do business with you, I have no money for food.
I can't make commission on this.
$5.40? Maybe I can give my children some dry bread.
I have to check with my customer. 35. My customer says too much.
No, he doesn't. I know you understand Gujarati. That's why I lied.
And I know you know I know Gujarati. And I know you know Yiddish. I was speaking to an answering machine.
520 as a wedding present. Mazel.
I'm sorry, I can't shake your hand. I'm not allowed to touch any man who isn't my husband. Mazel.
And mazel for your wedding. Mazel for the dozen children you'll soon have.
Thank you. Is that your children?
Munish and Parish.
Where's your wife?
Oh, she's not looking that good in the photographs these days.
Oi.
Last year she decided that marriage was a sin. Now she's in India, with her head shaved, going door to door, collecting food in the bowl. She used to be my wife. Now I have to worship her.
Don't worry. She's not the only one without hair. I had to shave off all mine this morning because I'm getting married tomorrow. This is a wig.
Why? What is so wrong with women's hair anyway? Why you all want to cut it off?
They wanted me to cut it off on my wedding night. I said, no way.
Yeah.
It took 25 years to grow. 10 minutes to cut off. And now, for the rest of my life, I have to wear some other woman's hair.
For all I know, you could be wearing my wife's hair right now.
What do you mean, your wife's hair?
Most human hair in America comes from our temples in India, where women offer their long locks to God, so that they can be sold to the West and you can have your wigs. While we are waiting for the Messiah, while we are waiting for Mahavir, your eyes will suffice to give tired men hope.
We're not the brumbies in this neighborhood.
Je viens de là-bas. Je suis née au Mali.
Oh, c'est magnifique. Je suis haïtien, moi.
Ah ouais.
Ouais. Mais j'aime beaucoup la musique de l'Afrique de l'Ouest. Alors, ma sœur, on va où?
On n'a qu'à rouler. J'ai envie de finir avec ta musique. Ça va avec toi?
Ah oui, ça va, y a pas de problème, c'est parti.
Ok, c'est cool.
Dida, dida, dida,
seola. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Wow, that's an entrance. Wait, which way are you going?
Oh, I was just gonna go across down the east side.
Oh, I guess I can film there too. Okay, let's go.
On y va.
Oh, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hello.
David? Are you okay? Did I wake you?
Yeah. Yeah, you can sit down.
Listen, he left me a message about a couple of music cues.
Who?
Abara, your director.
Okay, which ones?
5, 7, 8, 12, 13.
Okay, okay, great. What was the message?
He hates them. You have to change them.
Because?
He didn't say.
Well, what do you think, Camille?
Maybe you should talk to him directly.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll call him.
Hey, Camille. It's a favorite stalker.
Did you talk to Abara?
Yeah, we talked. He talked.For like 2 hours about like composers, Wagner, Brahms, Gustav Mahler, Tchaikovsky, Dostoevsky. That killed me.
Dostoevsky isn't a composer. Are you okay?
Never better.
Great. Well, I need your address. Abara wants to messenger you something right away.
Does he? Hold on. It's on my phone.I'm a total idiot when it comes to numbers and addresses. My last girlfriend.
Huh?
I can never remember her birthday. She broke up with me because of that.
Yeah, well, you deserved it.
Probably, but the upside is that I'm single now, so dinner?
You're sleep deprived, David.
No, I'm Camille deprived. I'm thinking Balthazar for dinner and maybe a little pastis for dessert.
I'm thinking unemployment if you don't finish his cues on time. Give me your address.
Hello?
Hey, did you get the books? I left them outside your door.
Wait, what, you were here? Why didn't you call?
I knocked like 100 times.
What the hell is this?
He talked to you about Dostoevsky.
Please read. Is this guy crazy? Am I supposed to read these or eat them?
Okay, David, I'm gonna put you through to Abara, okay? You can talk to him.How'd it go with Abara?
He just said, read the books, Dave. Don't use Cliff Notes or Wikipedia, just read them. So, fine. I'm on a bench in Central Park with the Brothers Karamazov. 800 pages and I'm on page 22.
Ouch. Bless you.
Thanks.
What? What's wrong?
I can see the Dakota. John Lennon is my god. You know his song Mother?
Yeah.
I was a kid the first time I heard that. Why can't I write a song like Mother? Oh, I just sent you a picture.
Oh my god. Is that John Lennon standing behind you?
What?
I'm just kidding.
I have no idea what you look like, Camille. Send me a picture.
No.No way.
Is that what you look like?
If you're calling for Camille, please leave a message after the beep.
There are 1,784 pages, and it takes me 4 minutes to read one page. 1,784 pages times 4 minutes a page is 7,136 minutes, which equals 118.9333 hours, which comes to 4.955 days. But you can round it off to 5 days without sleeping. It's impossible. I quit. I quit. Goodbye, Camille.
Hello?
Please leave a message after the beep.
Hey, David, it's Camille. You know, when Dostoevsky was writing The Gambler, he signed a contract with his publisher saying that he would finish it in 26 days. And he did it, but he had the help of this young stenographer. This girl, she stayed with him, and she helped him. And afterwards, they actually got married. Isn't that cool? That's how he met his wife. Anyway, I found this story in the preface for Crime and Punishment. So I was thinking that, and this would have to be between you and me, but I was thinking that I could read the books and tell you what's going on, and that way you could just focus on your music. But only if you're comfortable with this. And if you're not, you know, we can just forget it and you can quit. But if you are, then open this door.
Open this door?
Deal's a deal.
Does this mean we're getting married?
I have a lot of reading to do. Hi, I'm Camille.
Hi, I'm David.
Thank you.
That was kind of a powerful, intimate situation.
What was intimate?
Just now, just we sharing the flame. I mean, that was intimate.
You say so.
Oh, come on now. You know what I'm talking about. I mean, our hands almost touched. I looked at you and you lifted your head up slowly and our eyes met. It was intense and it was intimate.
Wow. Stop it. I feel naked.
Yeah, well, you know what? I have that effect on women. I mean, not all women. No, not all women. But it has happened before, so don't be alarmed.
Yeah, I bet.
Yeah. Don't ignore what's happening here. We're having some kind of powerful, weird alchemy, and you have to pay attention when that happens. Stuff is not to be treated lightly.
Listen, I actually just came out here to have a cigarette, okay, and relax do my thing.
Sure. Yeah.
So, maybe another time.
Yeah, but there may not be another time. Okay, I may never get this chance again. I mean, we may never, you know, be able to return to this moment.
Well, then you should know that I'm married and happy.
Right, and where is he? He leaves you out here alone in the dark without a light? I'm not feeling that.
Well, he doesn't smoke, so. Yeah.
But you love him anyway.
Yeah, why not?
Sure. Right? He just abandons you, to your mortal disease and leaves you alone to suffer and die when he's in there pretending to love you. I don't respect this guy. I think he's a coward. I think he's selfish. And forgive me for saying this, because I think any moment now, this guy's going to open up his real self to you and it's going to be all, like scary stuff's going to come out. You know, I felt it right away that I think, I'm going to say something a little bold here, but I think you might be married to the wrong person.
I don't know that even if that were true, that I'd tell you.
Right.
We're not exactly friends.
No, we're not.
No.
That's true. No, but we did share a flame, right?
Speaking of.
Oh, see, look at that. See, you need me. You're walking away and you need me. We share a flame. Thousands of tiny molecules are heating up right now. They're penetrating our brain. They're stimulating our sexual desire. I mean, I don't know about you, but I find that shit very romantic. And you know, I'm so glad you walked over here because now I can feel a little bit more comfortable to tell you that I happen to be on the forefront of men able to find and locate a woman's G-spot. And I could do that for you.
It's really generous of you.
Thank you. It's my pleasure. Well, it's your pleasure.
And what makes you think I haven't located it yet?
The way you hold the cigarette. It's a little high and tight. You know, what you have to do is you have to lower it. You have to bring it all the way down in there so it just sits comfortably at rest there. You know, if it's high and tight like that, the whole body gets restricted and the plexus gets closed off, you know, and the vagina gets locked. Look, I just happen to know this crazy, weird technique with the vagina, and it's kind of cool, and I thought you'd be interested, but you have to be prepared. You know, I mean, preparation is the key. I mean, it starts with a little walk, just a short walk, like, you know, like to like my apartment. It's a couple blocks from here. And we would walk and I would tell you a few little elegant, classy jokes, you know, kind of getting us a little giggly, a little silly, you know, and then we share a glass of Burgundy.
Burgundy?
Yeah. We bask in the warm, gentle, romantic, yet erotic glow of my spacious loft. And then I would undress you, and you would undress me. We'd stand naked before each other, and we'd kiss. I find kissing a very helpful, sweet way to relax. And then maybe I would bite your neck a little bit, not hard, just gentle little nibbles, like a little kitty cat, you know. And then then you would feel my hands kind of descend to your lower region, kind of finding their way, massaging the skin around your clitoris, which would even stimulate the arousal even more. All the time I'm whispering delicate little poems in your ear, you know, and the blood from your body is rushing to the wet internal walls, and my fingers would slide effortlessly.
Are you an actor or something, or a comedian? You're a comedian.
No, I'm kind of a writer.
Oh, you're kind of a writer.
Kind of. You know, what about you? What do you do?
I'm a hooker.
What exactly does that mean?
That exactly means that people pay to have sex with me.
Mm-hmm. So if I wanted to,
Here's my card. It's got my number and my website on it.
So, wow, you're a... That's... you're...
Fridays is no good. Saturdays and Sunday are busy. Weekends are... Avoid weekends. You know, I look forward to hearing from you and sharing another intimate moment.
Mm-hmm.
Well, fuck.
In New York City, there are currently 759 drugstores and over 1,600 registered pharmacists. On the day of my senior prom, one of them would change my life.
Shit bums. They lose 2-1 again. One run. They couldn't hit a ball with an oar. Listen, this is on a house. I heard about what happened with you and that girl you were dating. Oh. I'm really sorry. And on prom night. Like there's gonna be other proms. Well, there's not gonna be another prom. Not now, not ever. She's a whore, all right? Crushing a young man's dreams. She's a snake fucking devil whore is what she is. She's got no right.
It's all right. I mean, we only went out a couple months and I'm okay with it.
Here's the thing. I'm gonna help you. Come here for a second. I've got something to show you. That's my daughter. She'll go to the prom with you tonight. It's the right thing to do. Well, that's not chopped liver, right?
Nah.
I was 17 and I'd only been to second base, but I felt like tonight could be my lucky night.
Hey, kid.
Hey, Mr. Coley.
Hey, call me Frank.
Oh, hey. Yeah.
Look good.
Thanks.
Oh, thank you.
Listen, try to get her home by 12:30. She's got to take her pills.
Why are you stopping?
It's my girlfriend.
Hey.
Hi.
I'm sorry. I came with Gil. He's a film major at NYU.
Oh, that's cool. You know, we're cool, whatever. It's no biggie, you know. How's your swimmers here?
Good. Better. Who's your date?
Make a wish.
Yeah. You know, it was her dream to go to prom, and I said, of course I'll make your dream come true.
I want to dance.
We should talk first.
I want to dance.
Everybody clap your hands. Check it out, y'all. How low can you go? Can you go down low? All the way to the floor? How low can you go? Can you bring it to the top? Like it never, never stop?
Wait, that's my limo.
You got your own wheels.
Want to walk me home through the park?
Through the park? Thanks.
I had a really good time tonight.
Me too. I should probably take you home.
Make a wish.
I really can't think of anything right now.
Come on, take my panties off. Come on. Yeah, that's them. Okay. Okay, now take your pants off. Hurry. Come on. Come here. Grab my legs. That's it. It's morning.
Oh, fuck!
Motherfuckers.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
They lose it in the ninth. These rat bastards, they lose it 8-7.
8-7.
The Yankees need some pitching.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi, baby. Listen, I really want to thank you very much. There are not too many young men like you left in this city.
Well, it's my pleasure.
Yeah, New York actresses, they drive you nuts.
Actresses?
See, last year she played Helen Keller. She walked around the city for 2 weeks, blindfolded, you know, to get the feeling of the part. Broke her nose twice. Now she's doing this thing downtown. What the fuck? Whose life is it? Anyway, she's doing 20 hours a day in a chair now.
Central Park covers almost 843 acres. It is 6% of Manhattan. There are also 127,000 method actresses in New York, which is 2% of the population. And on the night of my senior prom, these two elements came together to make one perfect wish come true. God, I love New York.
Nothing. You know what? Give me a sec, right? I'm just gonna go say bye.
My man.
Alright. That's for you.
Now a little bit more practice.
I ain't practicing.
You had me going. You're good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Alright, let's go.
Said goodbye. Oh yeah, it was at the bar. Ugh, I didn't realize we were gonna go home together at that point. Idiot. Why did I do that? Why did I act like that? I'm only gonna have 2 drinks tonight. I'm not gonna have sex with him. I don't want to. I really don't. God, I had no intention of going home with him or anyone. When he sat down next to me, it was so clear we weren't each other's style. That it wasn't even weird. And since there was no vibe, we just started talking without thinking anything. And then I don't know what happened.
It's a bad idea with this girl.
What am I saying? She's not a girl. I have no idea how old she is, but she's not a fucking girl. Why am I walking 30 blocks to this bar? I'm not in a good space for this. Yeah, she was beautiful. Yes, she had a great body. She was smart. Was she even drunk? I don't even know. I don't even know what she was. Does it really matter? Am I imagining things or is my dick itching? No, no, no. It's just these pants. They always rub me the wrong way. God, that was sexy. It was beyond sexy. I feel like I was in a damn Bertolucci movie. What is wrong with me? Why am I so fucking nervous? This is ridiculous. Let's just get in a cab. No, you're too early. Shit. I need a cigarette.
I don't think I was drunk. Although I definitely had red wine teeth when I came home. I'm sure he found that really attractive as I sat at the bar yammering about myself. Oh, no wonder he was so excited when we got home. I finally shut the fuck up. Yeah, I hardly said a word the rest of the night after that. It was good, but there's nowhere for it to go. I think it would have been fine if it was just sex, but it took another turn. Something happened. I don't know what zone that was, but both of us played into it. It's good we're gonna do this. Have a couple of drinks and get straight. Let him know I know what this was. Nothing. God, I hate that window. I don't want to see the innards of the subway system. It makes me feel sick. Just get me there.
Jameson.
You left that on?
Yeah. I'll look at it later.
This is not the room I wanted. I don't find it comfortable so near to the street. Noise. I can carry my bags.
This is my job.
I was hoping it would snow. Then the street is quiet. The world goes quiet.
I don't think there is snow.
You're not American?
No. No, we are not so many of us American Jews at all.
It's one of the things I love best about New York. Everyone came from somewhere else.
Yeah. Well, I hope you will be very comfortable here. Please go down if you need anything.
There are no flowers. Is it possible to have flowers in the room? Violets? Expecting you to buy them, of course, if you don't have them.
I'm sure I can find some violets. I didn't do anything. You must have requested them. They were downstairs in the lobby.
I didn't.
All the better.
Incredible.
So
But you're lucky, no? These violets were waiting for you. Are there any other miracles I can perform?
Oh, I doubt it. What's happened?
I'm sorry.
Put your head back. Are you in pain? It's not my business. From your back?
I have something for you. Please. The mystery of the violet is solved. My father is manager here at hotel. He is very happy you have returned to hotel. He's very big admirer of yours, madam. He says he heard you sing many times in Paris.
Please thank him.
Paris is a place I wish I visit. Would you like me to open?
Would you join me?
I don't.
Please?
Something.
You seem so sad. No one so young should be so sad.
Do you still sing?
Never.
Yeah. I'm sorry. I should love to work, do you think? You're too cold.
Sure.
No? How can you bear it?
I don't know how you can bear it.
See anything? Did you see something in the street? Would you like me to close the window, madame? It is very cold.
Yes. Please close the window.
Manager is very happy that you've returned to the hotel. He remembered your love of violets and hopes you enjoyed them. He's a great admirer of yours, madame. Says that he heard you sing many times in Paris.
Yes. Please thank him.
Artist? Painter. I see the paint on your hands.
Uh-huh.
I'm a painter too. Already there's been some serious interest, you know? People like my stuff. I mean, they really like it. You've been here long? It's not easy here. I see things everywhere, don't you? It's all new. On the walls, on bridges, I see things. I get my palette from the sky. I wait and I paint. Don't you think when you first come here, you come because this is the capital of everything possible?
For a while, it can be.
I can make the buildings dance. Whole city's moving because of me.
It's how you look at things, Tay. You see the city between the buildings?
Mm-hmm. Huh?
You see the shapes they cut out in the sky?
Mm-hmm. Like mommy's teeth. Oops.
It's okay.
My umbrella's out of control. Going, going, going. It's everywhere.
You like
imagine if we're in a huge umbrella, if we're living in a huge umbrella. That'd be so weird. Because then you're gonna see a green or any color all the time. Why is that squirrel chasing the other squirrel?
Because he loves her.
Then why is she running away?
Because she's scared.
Can we go to the fountain now?
The fountain? You know, I don't remember where the fountain is. Do you?
Oh, no. Oh, no. Mama doesn't let me eat hot dogs.
You want sushi?
Seaweed's gross.
Then it's our secret, okay?
All right.
Excuse me.
Yeah?
We couldn't help but notice how good you are with her.
Oh, thanks. Thank you.
It's so unusual to meet a Manny.
And a good Manny at that.
What?
You know, a male nanny.
Well, thank you. Thanks. Excuse me. Thea, hey, come on, baby. Let's go, Mom. Come to work.
The sun's a boy and the moon's a girl.
Exactly, Tay. El sol, la luna.
La luna.
Yeah, that's right.
I like when they're both out.
Yeah?
They make all these pretty colors, and it's kind of like purple, hot pink, and then regular pink. And they sort of like play tag with each other. Well, they still can.
Nice outfit. Did you pick that out yourself?
Yep. And the bracelet matches.
It does. Ed's over there. He's got a snack for you.
No, thanks.
You're gonna get hungry.
Nuh-uh. I had a hot dog.
You need to be firm with her, okay? She needs a discipline.
She needs you. She misses you.
Pick her up again tomorrow?
Okay.
Come on, mommy.
Excuse me, all this for dry clean?
Yes, tomorrow, okay?
Why not? After 5. You've been shopping. Very expensive stuff.
I don't like to run out.
Wow, 好正 喎。 好頂癮 啊。 Wow, 好索 喎。
不要學死這個怪佬。
Your Cantonese is improving.
I've been studying. Have a nice night.
大家咁話，慢慢行。
Today.
Good.
I want to paint you, you know, portrait. Would you like to come with me?
1 minute.
No. I really no.
I can't.
Please. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm gonna give you my address if you change your mind. I'm waiting for you.
Hey, 把茶叶切细了。
because they cannot get enough of them. I mean, if people have a chance to use it, they will not use the treadmill, they will not use the stair stepper, they will not use the treadmill.
Hey, you looking for something?
I'm looking for the painter.
What?
The painter.
The painter is dead. You want an apartment?
Filming in the coffee shop?
I thought I was being more discreet. I guess my secret's out now. If you ask for permission, you never get anything, so...
So you like to break the rules, then?
A lot of people give me trouble.
Well, I will be the exception for today.
Oh, Sadie's full of surprises, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, Peter, how are you?
Yeah, of course. I'll get it to you in the morning.
No, they're very important clients. No, losing a client is not an option. Yeah. And?
Thank you.
No, I don't care. Tell him to postpone the opening.
Yeah, of course. And if their lawyer tries to contact...
Second offer.
Not yet. No. Okay, Peter. You too. Thanks.
You know, this is what I've always liked about New York. These little moments on the sidewalk, smoking, thinking about your life.
Makes you appreciate the city better. Mm. You can watch the buildings, you can feel the air, and look at the people. Sometimes meet somebody you feel like you can talk to.
You talk about what?
Things you can say to a stranger. You know, when there's no past, there's no guilt. Have you ever made love to a perfect stranger?
No, you're teasing me.
I believe I am.
Well, I mean, no, not exactly a perfect stranger, if you mean, well, someone I wouldn't know at all.
It's sad.
It's sad, why?
Because there's almost nothing more exciting than fucking somebody you don't know. Right? You don't know their name, barely saw their face.
Don't tell them your name.
You know what? As soon as I finish the cigarette, I have to walk back into that restaurant and sit down again in front of my husband.
And
he won't look at me. And he won't notice I'm not wearing a bra under my dress.
No bra?
No panties either.
Oh. No underwear?
Not today.
I feel sad for this poor, lonely husband who can't see his wife's hidden talents.
Don't you think he's like every man, though? He's typically blind and bored by his very own wife, ready to fantasize about the first unknown woman he hasn't fucked yet. Am I bothering you?
Not at all.
Yeah. And you say that because now I've turned you on, right? And you want to take me to bed. Do you want to take me to bed?
Yeah, I probably do. Oh, come on, all right. Why are you telling me all of this?
Because tonight I want things to change. Chain smoking's a bad thing. Who knows, maybe we'll meet again. Enjoy your meal.
What happened to you?
Oh, I was doing downward dog, and then I went into chakrasana, and that's when it happened.
What's a dama do?
Yoga.
Oh, yeah. You know, I remember you used to be really loose, and, you know.
Mr. Ricoli, can you just fill the prescriptions now?
No, what I was saying, I didn't mean loose.
Oh, no,
I meant limber.
I know what you're saying. I just have somewhere to be.
Right. What the hell? Who are you with? Birth control. What the hell are you doing?
Oh, come on.
No, listen, I'm just saying that, you know, I think, Lydia, personally, it's time for you to baby. So?
What, are you kidding me?
What?
What's wrong with you? Get out of here.
What'd I say? What did I?
You know, you used to be nice. What happened to you, huh?
Oh.
Hey, Lydia, come on. Talk to me. What'd I say? Hey. I'm sorry. What the hell did I say?
Babies.
You're picking on me again.
You know, I just don't understand why I'm always the one who has to initiate everything.
Not true.
We don't go anywhere. You don't take me anywhere.
I took you to the park last week.
Oh, come on. I'm talking about outside of the city. Name one place in the past 2 years outside the city that you've taken me.
Beach in the Hamptons.
That's when we met, and you hated the Hamptons. I'm talking about a road trip, or, you know, a canoe trip even, a bike trip. Will you stop at the phone? You just name one. Exactly. What?
If you could go anywhere in the world, where would you go?
You know where.
Come with me.
What are you doing?
I just bought tickets. We're leaving now.
Are you out of your mind? I don't have anything with me right now.
Well, I will buy you a toothbrush. In Rome. Coach is fine.
Lift your feet. You don't lift your feet.
I'm lifting my feet.
Oh, you're shuffling. The doctor said you should lift your feet.
I'm lifting.
Once you should fall down, break your other hip.
At least then the pain would be the same on both sides. Equal.
Everything always has to be equal with you.
I'm a democratic sort of fella.
Well, see how democratic you feel when you fall down and break your other hip.
I'm not breaking any hips. Is there some place you've got to get to later? What is your hurry?
My hurry is I want to get there before next week, at the rate you walk.
You want faster? Divorce me and get yourself a younger man. Tom Cruise, perhaps.
You think you're funny?
I do, as a matter of fact.
And what would you do, Mr. Smarty Pants, Mr. I'm so independent, I don't need any help opening the pickle jar?
I got caught in a pickle.
And will you just still be putting on your jacket if it wasn't for me? Go ahead, hit me, why don't you? Want to run me down? Oh, all the time honking like they owned the place.
We could have driven.
Who could have driven you? You're going to give me a heart attack now?
What's the good of having a car if I never get to drive it?
You can't drive. You can't even read the street sign.
I still have my license.
Only because that girl at the DMV took pity on you. All that flirting with her, it was embarrassing.
Brighton Beach Avenue.
As if you didn't know what street this was.
I know what street
this is. Of course you know what street
this is. You think I don't know what street this is?
Did I say you didn't?
I was reading the street sign.
Well, regular Evelyn Wood I married. Hurry up, it's green. The light's gonna change! Step up.
Okay.
You sure? We're not in any rush.
I said I'm okay.
Don't walk so fast. I don't want to have to call an ambulance. I don't want to think about trying to make that cell phone she sent us work.
Did you call her?
She called me.
What did she say?
What do you think she said? How are you? How is Dad? What are you doing?
And what did you say to her?
I told her we're doing the same thing we do every year.
Good.
She said she sent us a card, and did we get it?
Did we get a card?
Did you see any card?
Maybe it just didn't get here yet.
She probably sent it late.
Don't criticize.
I'm not criticizing.
You are criticizing.
She probably forgot and then remembered at the last minute. You wait and see. The postmark will be yesterday, as if it could get here from France in one day. Oh. Where are you going?
I don't want to take the ramp.
No, the ramp is easier.
I'll take the stairs.
You're going to kill me. Oh. Today of all days, he decides he'll finally kill me. Do away with me by making me take the stairs. Give me a heart attack just watching you take the stairs. They have smart police these days, like the cute one on CSI. They'll figure it out. It'll make headlines. Man kills wife on 63rd anniversary. Walking upstairs.
Them.
Let's go have lunch. Let's go. Come on. Let's go.
Well, I'm coming.
Lift your feet.
I'm lifting.
No, you're shuffling. Lift your feet.
I'm lifting.
Fix your hat a little bit. You looking okay with your hat?
Yeah.
Looking pretty good looking to me.
Thank you. Thank you.